Coming up in minutes on Action News at 5, French tourists trying to get home as investigators try and piece together the cause of a deadly bus crash. Swine flu concerns mounting. The disease is now spreading across the country. And the Fed saying that diet supplements sold in stores and over the internet are filled with hidden dangers, the problem that they could pose for your health. All that plus Jim with the weekend forecast. It's next.
You're watching KSBW Channel 8, Salinas, Monterey, Santa Cruz. Now, coverage you can count on. This is Action News 8.
A seismic shift in America's auto industry. One of the big three files for bankruptcy protection.
I don't believe it. I don't believe it, really.
Bad air in San Benito County. Why a new smog report gave them a failing grade and what they want to do about it. And our top story. Investigators trying to piece together the cause of a deadly tour bus crash. Good evening, everyone. I'm Dan Green. We are beginning tonight with continuing coverage of this week's deadly tour bus crash. We also have the latest details into how it happened. Action News reporter Mae Chow begins our coverage. She's live at the CHP office in Salinas, where this investigation is being operated from.
Dan, the CHP is still putting together the facts of this case and has not released any new information. What we do know this afternoon is that a highly trained team of crash investigators from the California Highway Patrol is handling the investigation. They are having to work with the remains of a tour bus that was crushed in the crash that killed four French nationals, and now we know the bus driver. We also know that 69-year-old John Robert Agnew pleaded no contest to a misdemeanor charge of accidentally striking a woman on a crosswalk in Las Vegas 3 years ago. Several passengers who were injured in Tuesday's crash remain hospitalized at this time, four of whom are listed in critical condition. Meantime, the Red Cross of Monterey County is helping survivors with temporary shelter and grief counseling. The agency is also working with the French consulate and the CHP in reuniting family members.
Split up because depending on their injuries, they were sent to certain hospitals. And at this time, as we are identifying the passengers, and at this time we do have all the passengers identified, we're trying to get them to their loved ones at this time.
So, Dan, clearly the CHP will have to speak with the survivors, and they are still going through this very traumatic period. Again, I went over to the Laurel Inn where some of the survivors are staying, and still today they were not able to speak on camera. Many questions still to be answered as to what was the driver doing moments before the crash. The CHP has not given us a timeline as to how long this investigation will last. Dan?
All right, May, thanks very much. We do not know when the survivors will actually be returning to France. The French consulate in San Francisco is helping right now with their travel arrangements. Continuing coverage now on the swine flu, also known as the H1N1 virus. In Santa Cruz County, 47 samples were sent to the lab. 30 have come back negative. The county is waiting for results on the remaining 17. Meantime, the Centers for Disease Control say that they have now confirmed 116 swine flu cases in 15 different states, including a member of the Obama administration just back from Mexico. Here's Action News reporter Tracy Potts.
The White House said today a member of the advance team for Energy Secretary Stephen Chu, just back from Mexico, probably contracted swine flu.
This person has been cleared to go back to work by doctors and is back working today.
There are no plans to test the secretary or President Obama. The White House also apologized for Vice President Biden's comments this morning.
I would tell members of my family, and I have, I wouldn't go anywhere in confined places now.
He specified subways and airplanes. That got the travel industry worried.
We employ one out of every eight Americans people stop traveling for rumor versus reality, and that puts people out of jobs.
Cruise ship passengers docked in Alabama today upset that their Mexican ports of call were skipped.
They overreacted, no doubt in my mind.
The government's official advice for avoiding swine flu hasn't changed.
Washing your hands, washing your hands, washing your hands.
Today, there are over 100 confirmed cases in at least a dozen states.
As we see more cases and more suspect cases, the numbers become a little murkier, and we'll focus more on where things are occurring.
Many patients, like this woman's daughter, have already recovered.
She's doing fine. She is no longer infectious.
But health officials warn.
We have to anticipate that it could become more severe.
So the government is shipping supplies to the border, sending CDC test kits to states so they can confirm their own cases, and ramping up production of flu-fighting drugs.
Even though we're now just one step away, the World Health Organization says a pandemic is not imminent. From Washington, I'm Tracy Potts, KSBW Action News 8.
You can get more information on the H1N1 virus, the swine flu, by logging onto our website at KSBW.com. You'll find all sorts of information on the virus and what you can do to protect yourself. There's a link to the CDC website. It's all on the homepage at KSBW.com. On the Crime Watch, a six-week investigation has led to the arrest of a suspected graffiti vandal that they say left a trail of paint all across Santa Cruz County. 21-year-old Cody Chirolo is charged with 27 counts of vandalism. Police believe he painted large murals on the front of businesses, ag equipment, and structures.